Today on The Brief, Google's parent company, Alphabet, scored a major PR coup last week by publishing and then quickly pulling a post on NASA's website. The move sent bits flying all across social media, all because Alphabet used the phrase quantum supremacy in the title. Even The Economist, the magazine renowned for its intellectual rigor, felt compelled to buy in. Here at Infotech, though, we maintained our restraint. Why? Well, it would take a whole lot more than the 53 qubits in Alphabet's quantum processor called Sycamore to reach such a momentous milestone. The real question is, was my favorite magazine duped, or is quantum supremacy really upon us? Let's take a step back. The phrase quantum supremacy describes the moment when a quantum computer is able to solve a problem that would be practically impossible for any classical computer to solve. The problem here is how to generate purely random numbers, a critical ingredient in securing communication channels. To date, this has only been possible by pseudo-random solutions. But a European upstart called Idée Quantique already has a portable commercial quantum random number generator. It's even been certified by the National Institute of Standards and Technology. They call it Quantis. So why all the fuss? Well, Quantis is not a computer. It's a specialized piece of quantum hardware. Sycamore, on the other hand, is at the very core of Alphabet's computer. Sure, technically speaking, what Sycamore can perform in a few minutes would take IBM's classical supercomputer Summit thousands of years to complete. But there's a catch. A general-purpose computer is not needed to produce a random number. You see, Alphabet used the phrase quantum supremacy, not because it could, but because it wanted to underline its position in the quantum race. Just like how runners on cross-country teams work in packs and accelerate past competitors when they perceive weakness, the NASA Alphabet team just issued its first challenge. Now you might be asking, how will Team IBM respond? For insights on that, take a look at our blueprint called Observe the Evolution of Quantum Capability, or give us a call to discuss this further. Because if quantum supremacy is finally upon us, it's most certainly on top of one very steep hill. That's food for thought.